Matrix determinants. The determinant of a matrix is derived. It's a derived value. That means we have to find it. That helps us find the inverse of a matrix. Now, the reason we might want to find the inverse of a matrix is so that we can divide, because sometimes we need division in order to solve stuff. So instead of division, we call it an inverse, but we're going to learn all about that later. The symbol for determinant is line with the letter name of the matrix and then another line. So it's exactly the same as the symbol for absolute value. So what it is we're taking all of the numbers in a matrix and turning it into one number called the determinant. That we're only going to do this with square matrices, and so they have to have the same dimensions, rows and columns, and we're actually only learning to do these with 2x2s. You can do them with 3x3s. I don't know if you have any on your assignment that are that big, but if you do have 3x3s, you can just do those with a calculator. But 2x2s are really actually quite easy. So, to find the determinant of a 2x2 matrix, we're going to multiply the top left number of our matrix with the bottom right corner, and then multiply the top right number with the bottom left corner, and then subtract the two numbers. The two products that we get, and then we get an answer called the determinant. So right here, let's suppose that the element in this corner is a number that we're representing with the variable a, and that this number right here in the top right corner is b, and this element right here in the bottom left is c, and this element right here in the bottom right is d. It means we're just going to take a times d, so those two kitty corner values. And then we're going to multiply b times c, and we're going to subtract these two numbers multiplied together from these two numbers multiplied together. And that's the determinant. That's it. Okay, I'm going to clear these out so that we can start fresh. So the first one's kind of already done for us here. Make sure you're paying attention in case I ask individual questions from some of you. So, we're going to find the determinant of matrix B. So we use this symbol right here. Line, B, line. That means we're finding determinant, right? So we multiply these two numbers together first. You always have to start in the top left down to the bottom right. So that's a 4 times 8. And 4 times 8 is 32. Then we're going to multiply the three numbers in, or the two numbers in the other two corners. So the bottom left, which is 3, and the top right, which is 6. So 3 times 6, which is 18. So we have one product from two of the numbers, kitty corner, and then another product from the other two numbers, kitty corner, and we subtract those two numbers in that order, and we get the answer, which for this problem is 14. So everybody try this for me on problem 2. Go ahead and pause your video if you're watching my video and pause it and try problem 2 on your own. All right, welcome back. We are going to find the absolute value, not the absolute value, the determinant of r, but it looks like I'm writing the absolute value of r, right? So what we're going to do is multiply negative 3 times negative 2. And then we're going to subtract and multiply 4 times 1. So that gives us 6 minus 4, because a negative 3 times a negative 2 is positive 6, and 6 minus 4 is 2. So that one has a determinant of 2. Okay, go ahead and pause and try the last one on your own. All right, so let's check this answer together. So absolute value symbols to represent that we're finding the determinant of n. We're going to take the top left and bottom right, so 2 times negative 2, and then we're going to take the bottom left and the top right, so negative 3 times 6, so we end up with negative 4 subtract negative 18. Well, subtracting a negative number is the same as adding a positive number, correct? So negative 4 plus 18 is 14. So those are really easy to do by hand. If you have a bigger square matrix, like a 3x3 or a 4x4, there is a way of doing the 3x3s by hand that's not too bad, but it's got a lot of work to it. And 4x4s are even more complicated. So what I would like to do is show you how to do these on Desmos.com, or you could use a graphing calculator to get a similar result. So here is Desmos.com. I've gone into Math Tools and chosen a matrix calculator. I'm going to go ahead and do a new matrix. I'm going to go ahead and check my answer on the last problem I just did. So I'm typing in the matrix 2, 6, negative 3, negative 2. So double check my numbers, hit enter, so I've got that stored. Now look in my list. Under new matrix, there's a bunch of places where I can choose the letter of a matrix that I'm going to use. Or there are some things I can accomplish. We don't know what all this means yet, but I do see a button that says DET. Guess what that means? Determinant. So I'm going to click on the button that says DET, and then because I just stored that in matrix C, I'm going to choose C to go in the parentheses, close the parentheses, hit enter. Well, actually, you don't even have to hit enter. The answer's right there. But I'm going to hit enter. There it is. And that problem we just did together, we got 14, correct? So going back to that problem right here, we got 14. So the calculator or Desmos calculator got the same exact answer by just typing that in one more time. Looks like this, DET parentheses matrix C, the determinant is 14. Okay, so I haven't explained yet what we're going to use these for. They are important in finding inverses, which allows us to divide. That will be another lesson.